The following is a class on the Bhagavad Gita as it is, 7th chapter, text number 2, given by His Divine Grace, A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Prabhupada, recorded on October 28, 1975, in Nairobi, Kenya.
Jnanam tehaṁ sabhijnanam idam bhakshami asi sataha Yajnyatya neha bhuya anyaj jnatabham avasishyate. Jnanam, knowledge. Krishna says to Arjuna that I am giving you perfect knowledge. So this is our process. We receive knowledge from the perfect person. There is no use getting knowledge from imperfect person. That is useless waste of time. When who is perfect person? Who does not commit any mistake? Who is never illusion, whose senses are not imperfect, and who is not a cheater. These are the qualifications, excellent. These are the symptoms of perfect person. First thing is, he does not commit mistake. Throughout the whole world, you study big, big men, they committed mistake. Hitler committed mistake, Gandhi committed mistake, Churchill committed mistake. Because to err is human. However big you may be, you cannot avoid mistakes because you are not liberated. So, these are the signs of becoming perfect man, that he does not commit mistake. Neither he is illusion. Illusion means to accept something as something. That is illusion. Just like we are accepting this body as myself. If you ask me what you are, I am Indian, I am Brahmin, I am this, I am that. Now what are these? These are all bodily concepts of life. This is illusion. Illusion means I am not this body. We have got experience. When a man dies, his relatives and children cry, my father is gone. But actually the father, the sons, who knew the body of the father as the father, there was illusion. Now after death he is coming to understand that my father is gone. Why your father is gone? It is like that. The same hand, legs, heads, coat, pant, everything is like that. Why do you say that your father has gone out? That means the real father he has never seen. He has seen the illusion of his father. This is called illusion. Is there any doubt? I am seeing you. What I am seeing you? I am seeing your body, your shirt, coat, pants, that's all. But, as Krishna said, that Dehinasmin Jathadehe, within this body, the real person is there. Just like within the shirt and coat, the real person is there. See, but the real person we never see, we see this hard coat pant, and we take this hard coat pant as this man. This is called illusion. To accept something for something else. The son did not know who is father. He is going on calling the hard coat pant the father as father. This is called illusion. To commit mistake and to become illusion, and even if we try to become perfect, our senses are imperfect. Just like we are very much proud of our eyes. Somebody, they say, can you show me God? Now how will you see? Now with my eyes. But your eyes are imperfect, that will not admit. He forgets that so long the light is there, I can see. My pride for possessing the eyes is valid so long the light is there. As soon as there is no light, in spite of possessing the eyes, I cannot see. So you can see under certain condition. If there is sunlight, then you can see. If there is no sunlight, you cannot see. So what is the value of your seeing? Imperfect eyes. So, similarly, our eyes are imperfect, our all senses are imperfect. We gather knowledge by the senses. Five knowledge gathering senses and five working senses and mind. So, if these senses are imperfect, then how can I gather real knowledge? And without getting real knowledge, if I preach, that is cheating. If you have no knowledge, then what? That's why so many scientists, philosophers, they're cheating. Actually, they have no knowledge that life cannot be produced by chemical combination. Still, they're cheating people throughout the whole world that life can be produced by chemical combination. And this cheating is accepted. So there are so many other things that claiming they have gone to moon planet, this, that. But according to Shastra, they are all cheaters. All cheaters. They cannot go. It is not so easy thing. It's like to enter your African city, African country, where there are so many rules and regulations, immigration, and you want to go to the Chandralok without any restriction, you see. Chandralok is the planet of the demigods. There the people live for 10,000 years, they are so advanced. Their comforts are many thousands better than the standard of comfort. And you want to go there without any passport and without any visa. From common sense. Can you enter anyone's country simply because you have got an aeroplane? But these things are going on. So, to accept knowledge from these rascals who commit mistake, who are illusion, who are cheater, whose senses are imperfect, is useless waste of time. This is the Shastric Indian. We should receive knowledge from the perfect. So, in all respect, who can become the perfect than Krishna? Krishna is accepted by Vedavyas, by Narada, by Arjuna, big, big, stalwart scholars, and personality, that he is the Supreme Personality of God. Just like this Bhagavad Gita. This Bhagavad Gita is recorded by Vyasa. The talks were between Krishna and Arjuna. And it was recorded by Vyasa's disciple, Sanjaya. And Vyasa, while writing Mahabharata, he put this dialogue within the Mahabharata. So why Vyasa put this conversation between Krishna and Arjuna in his authoritative book, Mahabharata? Mahabharata means Greater India. Bharat means Bharatvarsha. This planet was being called Bharatvarsha. So Mahabharata, the history of the whole planet. So Vyasa giving the history. Mahabharata is also Vedic literature. Mahabharata, Ramayana, the 18 Puranas, Vedanta Sutra, four Vedas, and then Upanishad. There are Vedic literature. So Mahabharata is authorized Vedic literature. And within the Mahabharata, this Bhagavad Gita is there. Therefore it is Vedic literature. So, unless it is authorized perfect knowledge, why Vyasa should put in his Mahabharata? Therefore it is perfect knowledge. Because it is spoken by the most perfect personality, Krishna. There is no question of mistake, there is no question of illusion. You can attain this also, state of life, liberated life. See, we have heard so many times liberation or mukti. Mukti means one who has no defects, as mentioned. That is mukti. Mukti does not mean one thinks himself that I have become Bhagavan, I have become Bhagavan. Vimukta manina. They have been called as rascals wrongly thinking that they are vimukta. Vimukta. Jannir vindakha vimukta manina. There are so many rascals. They are thinking that they have become mukta, liberated Narayan. They are thinking like that. Janneru bindakha vimukta mani. So, why they are, if they have become liberated, so advanced, and feeling that they have become Narayan, so what is the objection? The objection is, Jinnera Vindakha Vimukta Manina Tai Astabhava. They do not know what is Narayan, these rascals. Shankaracharya admits Narayana Paraha Bhaktyat. Narayan is not a being within this material world. That is Narayan. And they have become Narayan, Nama Narayan. Narayan is so cheap thing. Therefore, Shastra says, Janne Ravindakha Vimukta Manina. These rascals, they are thinking they have become Narayana. But they do not know what is Narayana. Janne Ravindakha Vimukta Manina. Why they do not know? Tayyastu Bhavat. They never try to understand what is really God. They thought God is very cheap thing, everyone can become God. So therefore they have been called vimukta manina. Real mukti is described in the Bhagavad. Mukti means mukti hitya anatha rupam. Mukti hitya anatha rupam sarupena avastiti. When one is cured of his madness and he is situated in healthy state, that is called mukti. So, here in this material world, everyone is mad. Somebody is thinking, I am king, somebody thinks I am minister, somebody thinks I am president, I am this, I am Narayan. So on. All madmen. All mad. Because it will be finished. His so-called conception of becoming this and that will be finished within few years. But he is eternal. He is thinking the temporary situation of becoming an American, Indian, or minister, or president, or this or that, how long it will stay. It will stay, say, 10, 15, or 50 or 100 years, that's all. But he is not for 100 years. He is nitya sasatayam nahannati hannavani sarire. But this rascal does not know. He is thinking, by chance I become minister or president or this or that, for some years this is my position. Jyātma buddhi. So that is the difference between mukti, mukta and bandha, bondage and liberation. So liberation means to be situated in its own real position. That is called real. So what is our position? If we become little sober, if we become little sober, then we can understand what is my position. So that is called meditation. Or dhira. Dhira satya namayati. What is that? Kulaji?
People are coming in and out of the door there.
Huh?
The people are coming in and out of the door here. If you close the door, then...
Out of the door?
The front door is just here.
No. You can keep it open. Come here, there is so much place, let them go. But children may not go. So just try to understand that I am thinking I am such big man, I am minister, I am president, I am this, I am Narayan, up to the last stage I am Narayan. But if we soberly think that if I am Narayan, then I must be the controller. I must be controller of everything. But why I am controlled by the toothache? As soon as there is some pain in the throat, I voluntarily go to a dentist to be controlled by him. Then how I become Narayan? In this way, if one studies his life, oh, that he will find it that is fully controlled by something more. Fully controlled. And that control is of the material nature. Who can say that he is not controlled by the material nature? That is not possible. Daivijhesagunavayimamamayadurattaya. Material nature will oblige you. You are very nice, good-looking young man. Material nature will not allow you to remain as very good-looking young man. You must become old man. Your teeth must fall down. Your hairs must grow grey and you look ugly. Why? But he does not think. This is called ignorance, ajnana. Therefore Krishna says, jnanam teham savidyam. I will speak to you about jnana. Everyone is an ajnana and falsely thinking that he is some very important person. This is ajnana. Real jnana, as will be explained here, is to receive from Krishna. The Krishna is giving knowledge in the Bhagavad Gita. He speaks in later chapters that The real gyan is to surrender unto me. This is real. Krishna will say in the 8th chapter, Bhavanam janmanam ante jnanavan mam prapadyate. Upon many, many births. So we are, today I may be minister and tomorrow I, after death I may become a dog. But that is not in my control. You cannot say that I am minister, I am this, I am that, I am high court judge or a very important man, so I am ordering material nature, although I shall die. Next life I shall become again high court judge or Narayana or something. No. That is not possible. You are fully under control. You have given a license to enjoy or suffer in this body, and in this body, as soon as it is finished, karmana adha yuvana strena, jantar rihu, then you get another body. So this gyan, even this gyan, the change of body is not there. Throughout the whole world, big professor, big educationist, they do not believe in the next birth. 99.94, they do not. But this is a fact. There is. Tathādehāntara, Krishna says. And we understand this also. Krishna gives this example. Vehinasmiṇyathādehi kaumāra yomanangyara. The child is becoming kumār. Kumār is becoming boy. Boy is becoming young man. Young man is becoming old man. So, these changes are going on. Still, he does not know that after this old body is finished, I shall have to accept another body. So this is ignorance. Therefore, we have to take knowledge from the most perfect personality of God, Krishna. This is your knowledge. So, jnanam te aham sabhijnanam. Sabhijnanam means with practical application. As there is theoretical knowledge and practical knowledge in scientific advancement, so simply theoretical knowledge will not help me. Theoretically, I may know that I am not this body, but practically, it must be known. If not, if I am not this body, I am soul, then I am working here in this world only for my body. What I am doing about my soul? That is knowledge. Suppose I have got this coat and pant and hat. If you simply try dry clean the coat and do not put any food in the stomach, how long this civilization is gone? Starving? So the whole world is in the starved condition because there is no spiritual food. Only material. Cleansing the heart and coat. That is me. Like cats and dogs, they are interested in the body. So, vijñānam, actually we must know what we are and what is my real business. That is stated in the Bhagavad Gita. You should carefully note it. That when I understand that I am not this material body, aham brahmasmi, I am spirit soul, I am Brahma. Krishna is for a Brahma. And we are Krishna's part and parcel. We are also Brahma. Not that by knowledge I become Brahma. I am already Brahma. By ignorance I am thinking not Brahma. Aham Brahmasmi. I am spirit soul. I am spirit. That is my actual position. And when you understand your actual position and act accordingly, that is called mukti. Mukti hitya anatharupam sarupena avasthiti. When you understand that we are not this body, we are working whole day and night like cats and dogs, the hogs. The hog is also working day and night. What is his business? Where is stool? And as soon as he gets stool, he eats it, becomes fatty, because stool contains all the vitamins. That is the essence of all good food that you take, and the essence is rejected. But it is scientifically true, perhaps the doctor will admit. Stool contains all hypophosphites, is it not? Then who is going to eat stool? The hypophosphites is very good for brain. But now eat, therefore these hogs very easily become fat. Okay? So does it mean that we shall work very hard to find out where is stool and then become fat and somebody will eat me? This is not civilization. Civilization is that you must know what is your real position and act accordingly, and then you become liberated, sarupena avasthiti, that is perfection of life. Don't be misled by the bodily concept of life. That is condemned, the whole Vedic civilization is based on this point. Yashyatma buddhi kunapeti dhatuke sadhik kalatradishu bhoma ijyadhi jatitha buddhi salilena karhiti janesu abhidyesu saeva gokhar. Anyone who is acting on the bodily concept of life, saeva gokhar, they are no better than the cats and dogs. So that is going on all over the world. I am Indian, I am American, I am African, I am this body, all body. I am Hindu, I am Muslim, I am Christian, I am black, I am white, I am fat, I am thin, that's all. So, that jnana, theoretical, and vijnana, sabijnana, bhakshami, Krishna will teach. Take this jnana. The most perfect personality. This is our business. We don't care for Krishna. We do not know Krishna. And what to speak of taking knowledge from him? The knowledge is there. But we are so fools that we do not take knowledge from Bhagavad Gita. We manufacture our own knowledge. This is called Maya. Maya is so strong that she will not allow to take real knowledge from the real person, but we shall read volumes of books who are defective with their four kinds of imperfectness. Means they commit mistake, their illusion, their cheater, and their senses are imperfect. So this is the first business, that where we shall take knowledge. The tadvijnanartham, Vedic lesson is, the tadvijnanartham gurumeva vidachet, you should go to Guru. Just like Arjuna has accepted Krishna as Guru. When Arjuna was puzzled, he surrendered to Krishna. Tishasteham sadhimam prapanyam. I am kshatriya. It is my duty to fight, but I am declining. Although you are requesting me to fight, still I am declining. So I am puzzled. Anyway, I can understand you can drive away this puzzling position. Therefore, I am becoming your shishya. Shishyasteham. I become your disciple. I am not going to argue with you on equal footing. Shishya means he is always subordinate. Whatever the Guru will say, he will accept. That is the Guru and Shishya. So Krishna became Guru and Arjuna became a Shishya, disciple, not friend. Of course he knew what is Krishna. Vasishtasteham sadhimam prapannam. So similarly, we have to find out Guru for perfect instruction. That is the only. Otherwise, we shall keep ourselves in ignorance, in mistake, in illusion, in imperfectness, and so many other things. So, this is the injunction of the Vedas, that if you want real knowledge, you must go to Guru. Now there are so many Gurus. Where shall I go? No. You shall go to a Guru. Samitpani Sutriyam Brahmanistham. You shall go to a Guru who is Brahmanistham, a great devotee. He is Guru. Not a so-called Guru, gold-making Guru. There are other cheaters. You see? So, the Vedic injunction is Brahmanistham, that is Guru. One who has full knowledge in Brahma, atato Brahma Jivyas. So, here also in the Bhagavad Gita you will find who is Guru. Tattva-darshana, one has seen the truth. Never says this magic prayer. No. Tattva-darshana, this is the greatest magic. Brahmanistham, that is the greatest magic. How to become fixta in Brahma, that is called Brahma-bhuta, prasanna-atma. As soon as you become Brahmanistham, fixed up in Brahma, then all your miserable condition finished. Prasanna. That is the sign. And everyone is trying to be very happy. So that you can be by Brahmanistham, by understanding that you are Brahma. Brahma-bhuta, prasanna-atma. Na-socati, na-kāṅkati, samas-sarveshu-bhūteshu. Madhvakti Bhavati Param. These are the preliminary stages to enter into the kingdom of devotion. Madhvakti Bhavati Param. After going through this process, Brahma Bhuta Prasannata Nasojati Nakangati, Samas Sarveshu Bhutesu, then you come to the transcendental platform, and that is the business of Brahma Bhuta state. So, Jnanam means to understand oneself, and practically, saman vijnanam, sabijnanam, with vijnanam, practical application, idam, bhakhyami, and Krishna is saying, he is not ordinary human being. As soon as we think of Krishna as ordinary human being, we become more rascal. Abhijananti māgamūrha mānasintanuāsita. Because I am speaking this Bhagavad Gita, the ultimate knowledge, these rascals sometimes think of me as I am ordinary human being. And therefore, they interpret in their own way. What Krishna has said, the meaning is like this. As if Krishna left the whole book to be interpreted by another rascal. No. You cannot interpret. Therefore, we are presenting Bhagavad Gita as it is, without any interpretation. So if we take Bhagavad Gita as it is, and everything is there clear, don't interpret like fools and rascals, then you will get real knowledge. Jnanam, jnanam tehaṁ sabhijnanam, practical. Bhakṣāmi aseṣatā. So we must have understood that this is another meaning, that tad-vijñānānta-guru-mayo-abhigacche. So Krishna is showing practically by accepting his friend, very dear friend, as his disciple. That means he is showing who is Guru. Guru is Krishna. and one who understands Krishna. That is good. Don't accept these rascals and fools as guru, who denies Krishna. He's not guru. He's teacher. Krishna is right. Not just accepting. Shishya Sreham. I become your Shishya. That means Krishna is the original guru. And one who speaks on behalf of Krishna, he is guru. That is guru. This is the test. Whether he is aware of Krishna, then he is guru. Otherwise he is not guru. First of all, you understand that. So that is Mahatma. Krishna has said, Sa Mahatma Sudullava. That is Mahatma. Who Mahatma? Bhavanam Janmanavanti Jyanavan Maham Prapadate. Vasudeva Sarvameti. Sa Mahatma Sudullava. After many, many births of cats and dogs and trees and these and that, so many, 8 million. When one comes to this knowledge, Vasudeva Sarvamiti, Krishna is everything. Samahatma Sudhira. He is Guru. Guru means Vedic injunction, you must go to a Guru. Now, it may be difficult. Who is Guru? That is also Krishna saying, I am Guru. Matta paradaram nanna kimchi jasti dhananjaya. There is no more any better person than me. And he has proved it. He has proved it. Krishna, so long he was on this platform, on this earthly planet, he proved that he was the greatest personality. Greatest personality. Read history and you'll see. He proved himself from his child. When he was 3 months, he is neither old nor there, but he was playing just like human child on the lap of Mother Yashoda. The Putana came to kill him. So that child, you will read all this from Bhagavatam, how he killed that big Putana. When he was 7 years old, how he leaped at Govardhan Hill. So although he was playing, just like ordinary human child, human boy, but sometimes he was showing his almightiness. That is Krishna, that is God. So, jnanam sriyam sabi jnanam ilang bhakshanya sriyasatva. And just get that. If you try to understand Krishna and knowledge from Krishna, jajgyatya. Jajgyatya neha na iha in this material. Jajgyatya neha bhuya annad. You will have nothing to learn. Because he understands Vasudeva Sarvamidam. Everything is Vasudeva. So Vasudeva will give him all knowledge about science, about politics, about philosophy, about astrology, astronomy, everything will come out. You haven't got to go to some other expert in some particular type of knowledge. But if a devotee, Krishna devotee, he knows everything. All departmental knowledge. Just like we are challenging that you cannot make any light by combination of chemicals. Why? That we know from Krishna what is what. That we can challenge. We are not fools. We are challenging that if you can prepare one egg only. It is very easy. You can take any egg and analyze what are the chemicals. Then bring that chemical, put together, and give it to the incubator and produce a chicken. Then I shall know the chemical combination can produce life. What is your opinion, doctor? Is there any chemist here? It's simply cheating. Simply cheating. It is not possible. But we know that life cannot be produced by any chemical combination. Because we understand from Bhagavad Gita that mama imamsa jiva bhuta. The jiva, the living entities, is part and parcel of Krishna. So how it can be prepared by chemical composition? It is not possible. There are so many things. So therefore Krishna says that if you study knowledge which I am giving to you, jagyatta, perfectly, then na hiya bhuyas anna jnanam. Other department of knowledge will be manifest automatically. You will know everything. This is the secret. Jajgyatta neha bhuya annaj gyata bamma vasishyate. You haven't got to learn departmentally anything else, just see. This is the benefit. This is the benefit of Krishna consciousness. That you haven't got to work hard to understand other departmental knowledge. You simply try to take this knowledge and you will be perfect. This is Krishna consciousness. Thank you very much. Any question?
Are there any questions?
गुरुधारण के लिए तो पहले सबमिशन होना चाहिए. गुरु जी हम मूर्ख हैं, हमको आप ग्रहण कीजिए. जैसा अर्जुन बोला था, शिष्य से हम साधिमान प्रपन्नम, आई एम सरेंडर टू यू, यू गिव मी नॉलेज. What is that?
Well, he's asking, when did you become the spiritual leader of Krishna consciousness?
When my Guru Maharaj ordered me. This is the Guru Parampara. Try to understand, don't go very speedily. A Guru can become Guru when he is ordered by his Guru. That's all. Otherwise, nobody can become Guru. Sadhimang prapannam, I am surrendered to whatever you say, I shall carry out. That's all.
When did you tell you?
Now what is the business? When did you tell me? And why should I disclose to you? It is so very insignificant thing that I have to explain to you.
I'm just curious to know when.
You should be curious within your limit. You should know that one can become guru when he is ordered by his guru. This much.
Is that as good as thinking about Krishna? If we think about our spiritual master, is that as good as thinking of Krishna?
Yes. Because it is saying, dasya prasadat bhagavat prasad. If you can please your guru, then you please Krishna. So if you make always this plan, how to please my guru, then he will please Krishna. What is that?
Srila Prabhupada, what is it said in the Bhagavad Gita that if one thinks in the time of death, if he thinks of Krishna, he goes to Krishna. What is it one thinks of his spiritual master?
He will go to Krishna. The spiritual master is also going to Krishna. Now this question should be on the subject matter which I've discussed. Don't bring outside question, then there it will be no end. This is not the process. When we invite question on the subject matter which have spoken. Anyway, any other question?
In Back to Godhead, on page 5, it is said that Sri Guru Vallabhacharya ji, a devotee to Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, wrote commentary on Srimad Bhagavat, and Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu rejected his commentary. And then he said that he is not prepared to listen to his commentary, and he gave certain other comments.
Not certain other comment. The Vallabhacharya, he brought his Subodhini Tika, and he was great admirer of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, and he said that I have written one commentary which is far better than the comments given by Sridhar Sai. So that was disapproved by Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. If you disapprove previous acharya, or if you become more intelligent than previous acharya, then you are not acharya. This was Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. He disapproved. Our process is evam parampara praptam evam rajasya yogiti. We cannot disregard the Sridhar Swami, the original commentator of Bhagavad. If you say that I am better than Sridhar Swami, then you immediately become rejected. If I say that's like there are some people, they create some avatar and they say this avatar is better than Krishna, immediately rejected. Immediately. He must know his value. This was Chaitanya Mahaprabhu said, Swami, Sridhar Swami, so he also sarcastically remarked, Swami Deva Nahi Mane Besha Bole Goni. Swami means husband also. So if some woman says that I don't care for my husband, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, then he is a prostitute. This is Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. You cannot disregard Swami. Not that they are very friendly, so you can take it as friendly, jokingly, that you are so proud that you are disregarding Sridhar Swami. Then you are no better than prostitute.
Say that from the Vedas we know that Krishna is unlimited, especially when he was performing his Rasa-lila with the gopis. Mm. So, but if Krishna is unlimited, why did he not
manifest himself all over the world like all living entities,
Why did he not manifest himself all over the world so that all living entities could have equal chance?
Yes, he manifested all over the world. But you have no eyes to see him. That is your defect. Krishna is present everywhere. But just like sun is present in the sky, why don't you see now? Answer this. Do you think the sun is not in the sky? Do you think the sun is not there? So go on the roof and see the sun. Why you prove yourself a rascal? That no, there is no sun. Will it be accepted by learned men? Because you cannot see the sun, there is no sun. Will it be accepted by any learned scholar? At night you cannot see the sun, So if you say to any learned man, any who knows things, no, no, there is no sun. So will you accept that? He will say, the sun is there, you rascal, you cannot see. That's all. You just get out of your rascaldom, then he'll see. Naham prakasa sarvasya jugumaya samabhritam, Krishna says. He's not exposed to the rascals. But one who knows he's seen premanyana churita bhakti vilochane na santa sadaiva hridayeshu vilokaya jan shyama sundaram asindha guna. The devotee is always Sri Krishna. For him, he is always present. And for the rascals, he cannot be seen. That is the difference. So you have to become non-rascal, then he will see. Ishvara sarvabhutanam riddhe se arjuna tishti. In everyone's core of the heart, Krishna is present. But do you know that, can you see, can you talk with him? He lives in your heart. He's present. But he talks. With whom? Tesam satadujiktanam bhajatam triti purvatam dadami buddhi yogam. He talks with the devotee, who is 24 hours engaged in his service. He has taken in Bhagavad Gita. Don't you read Bhagavad Gita? So, everything requires qualification. So this Krishna consciousness movement means you are trying to make the people qualified to see Krishna. Without being qualified, how can you see? That requires qualification.
So, Lord Krishna is showing Vishva Swarup.
Yes.
So can you show me something about that Vishva Swarup?
You ask me? So am I Krishna? Why are you asking foolishly? That means you do not know Krishna. You are thinking me as Krishna. That you are a foolish man. Then why you are asking Vishwarup?
Vishwarup, because
Vishwarup will be shown by Krishna, not by not Krishna. I am not Krishna.
No, I am not saying you are Krishna, but you are something about.
I am Krishna's servant. What Krishna says, I am carrying. That's all. That is my position. I am peon. When the peon delivers 1,000 rupees or shillings to you, it is not his money. The money is paid by somebody, by the honesty delivered to you. Yes.
But Krishna is not giving you power?
Yes,
yeah,
yes.
Yeah. So you can't...
No, I am not so powerful that I can show the Vishnu. He has given me this power that you go and speak to the foolish rascals that I am Bhagavan. That much. Yes. That is my power. I can say to you that Krishna is Bhagavan, that's all. I never become equal to Krishna.
Why was people this kind of worship Lord Shiva instead of worship Lord Krishna? Because Krishna known as God.
Because they can get immediate money from Shiva. That is the reason. Lord Shiva is the proprietor or the supreme person within this material world, and he is Ashutosh, very easily pleased. Therefore, materialistic person go to him for some material benefit, and he gives. That's all.
Do Shiva is a very
wise
Vaishnava?
Huh? Yes, everyone is Vaishnava. He is the greatest Vaishnava. Vaishnavanam yathasambhu. Unless he is Vaishnava, how he gets his power? The power comes from the original person. matta smriti jnanam apohanam. So unless one is Vaishnava, he has no power.
Then Chaitanya Mahaprabhu was accepting a sannyasa order. He refused that jnana he was being given by his guru. And he accepted to keep Krishna Chaitanya as his name, which was a Brahmacharya. Why was that?
What is that?
When Chaitanya Mahaprabhu took sannyas, his guru offered him one name, but he refused and preferred to keep the name Krishna Chaitanya, which is a brahmachari name. Why was this?
Because he took sannyas from a Mahavadi sannyasi, and Mahavadi sannyasi, they think of themselves as they have become Narayana. But Krishna, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu refused to accept that theory that he is Narayana. He preferred to remain a brahmachari than to become a false sannyasi and claim to become Narayana.
Sure.